Red Hill. There he goes, right through the red light. Oh! Officer's ready there for him.
Yes.
Oh, he's going around that car. Oh. To the street, and as he comes into the intersection here, red light, he's going to go across lanes. There he goes, wrong side of the road. Traffic here, he's going to go blow right by those cars there and continue southbound. From the tight situation there. We don't know if there's anybody else in the vehicle, but look at, there's the couple units that are getting involved in the Percet shoulder to get around all this heavy traffic. He's got traffic for miles and miles, and he's got a car there. Oh, he just climbed. And then certainly can make it way. But he's, look at, he's going through some construction cones there. Wow, very dangerous. And I don't know if there's any Caltrans up ahead, but oh, he just hit that car. Ugh. Terrible, terrible situation for that driver. Yeah, unsuspecting. Yeah, he's... No! Ugh. Ugh. Oh, no! He might be carjacking. He might be doing a carjacking here. He's getting out. He went into the back seat for something. His car is smoking, so no, he's going to take off. I thought for a moment there they might try to carjack an apartment complex, and he's going to push his way through, and he's got another car. He's got trouble right there. How is he going to get around this? Oh, he's getting out. No, no, he's carjacking that vehicle. It looks like it's a female. He pushed her out of the vehicle. Such a danger. This man's going to try to help. This is a terrible situation. He's trying to fight them. He's got nowhere to go, though. Oh, that's terrible. That man's got to get out of there. He's trapped. He could get squeezed right there. He needs to back off and just let this guy take that vehicle. Look out. Wow. This is a terrible situation. They're hot on his track. There's the officer coming into the screen. Yeah. So now he's going to come back out, and it looks like the officers are getting ready up ahead to pin this guy in. There's a pedestrian getting out of the way. They could be pinning him in there. Oh, no, he went right through that intersection. So turn pocket. He's got some room to go there. No, he's got another car. He's going to have to jump the center divider. There he goes, jumping the center divider into oncoming traffic. And that's going to be a left turn. Hopefully it was just the woman there. But this is still westbound on Michelson. And oh, look at him, hard on the brakes there. He even kicked up some sparks. He's going right through the jamboree. Yeah. It looks like he might be on a rim now. Oh no, he's gonna hit that car. Oh man, he just sideswiped that car there on the right hand side. Instead of that right rear. Oh, he's gonna get out again. He's got his door open. Oh man, so dangerous. Oh, he hit right up on the grass and continues on. This is Von Carmen, I think. Oh, he's at 8 o'clock, Patrick. 8 o'clock. 8 o'clock. 8 o'clock. He's out on foot now. He's trying to run. And he's running up this hill. He's going 10 o'clock, Patrick. 10 o'clock. Keep it coming around. It's a business complex, business area. He's got the dog coming at him. The dog takes him down right there. 12 o'clock, Patrick. 12 o'clock. The dog got him. The dog made the tackle right before he got into that business.
Night, Necro thought. Could it be his madness caused by the taint? Is it still there? Anvil noticed for the first time that he was shielded, which they never did to captives unless letting their dose of fork root wane so they could be turned.
What the hell are you doing?
That sent a spike of panic through him.
What are you doing?
For him next?
Move! Move!
The bar sent. I have an idea.
Move!
Anvil started coughing through his gag. Evan jumped, then came over, bringing out his water flask and pouring water on the gag. Abor's, one of Taim's flunkies, lounged against the wall.
What are you doing?
Shield. He glanced at Anvil, but something at the other side of the room drew his attention. Anvil coughed worse, so Evan untied the gag and rolled him to the side, letting him spit out the water. Quiet now, Evan said.
Got the number 3 lane shut down. Well, ma'am, you've got to pull over when we stop. It doesn't matter, ma'am. Come on out. I've got an ambulance coming for you.
You need help?
Hey, Sheila.
I'm so sorry. It sounds kind of crazy.
Come on. Can you come out?
Come on, Ed.
Okay. I got an ambulance coming.
Can you try to, like, make the seat lean back?
I did. I pushed it back as far as it would go. Because it was lined up as far as it'll go back.
Oh, my gosh.
Am all you have to know, she's got blood all over. Here, grab the door right here. Over here.
I lost my shoe.
I will take care of it. Go sit down over here, okay?
Lift me over. Oh.
Sit down right there. We call it a pit maneuver when people flee from us or don't stop from us. That's what happened, okay? Do you need to sit down since you're ready?
No.
All you had to do was pull over,
man. Can you please call my husband?
Yeah, we'll take care of that here in a minute. You don't have your cell phone. Do you mind calling? You could hit like star 67 and a block of call. What's his number?
501.
13 to run.
Love you, how to do your room, Mama. Do you have
to? Oh, my God.
Ich muss die Kamera
nehmen.
Hey, Beeps. Ich habe das schon.
Ada bus kan memang depan kok ada bus. Wah gila tabrakan. Wow kebakar. Wah gila. Abebrit parah. Iya gila. Ini lagi jajan depan gua nih. Iya, gila. Aduh, gila. Kepala sama kepala tabrakan. Iya, ini yang mobil samping gua ngebut. Itu lan kan ditutup lan 4.
Why is he rolling back? Oh shit, he's going to hit me.